Hey guys, what's up? It's Philando, and I'm doing another video where I go over some of my favorite albums from the last few months and just sharing my thoughts on them. So first up is the New York noise rock band Modo Actrice, who smashes into the scene with some punishing industrialism, queer theatrics, and meditative dance punk on their debut album Dog's Body. It's a front-loaded record, and the influences of bands like Shushu and Swans are very apparent, but Dog's Body brings the chaotic gay energy like nothing else right now. Following that, Scaring the Hose is the debut collaboration between JPEG Mafia and Danny Brown, and it's a thrilling and unique project that showcases the dynamic range of both artists. The album is a masterful blend of JPEG Mafia's experimental hip-hop production style and Danny Brown's unique flow. The duo delivers a force of creativity and originality, and together their abrasive energy is unmatched. Next up, Isaac Wood's departure from the art rock band Black Country New Road was always going to be difficult to overcome, as his sincere performances were such a key tenet to the group's sound, but live at Bush Hall is by no means a misstep, as the remaining band members still bring emotive performances and beautiful compositions to the table. Next up, Girl in the Half Pearl is the second full-length release for the experimental R&B artist Liv, and it really takes the genre sonically farther and thematically further. Because of the fractured, whimsical makeup of the album, it can be hard to pin down, but its intriguingly chaotic clashes of melody and hazy vocals all inexplicably mesh together. Following that, with their latest record, Praise the Lord Who Chews But Which Does Not Consume, or simply Hop Between Worlds, the experimental producer and songwriter Eve Tuma transcends even further, dipping into electronica, alt-pop, and punk territory, and landing on a collection of songs that are equally bizarre and delightful. Next up, Fever Ray's self-titled debut album in 2009 was an incredible synth-pop album, and the duo's latest record, Radical Romantics, is a real return to form. Their trademark, buzzy, warped melodies, sinister production choices, and Karen Dreijer's eccentric singing form a hypnotizing collection of songs on love. Following that, Slow Tide's latest album, Ugly, is experimental, disarmingly honest, and conceptually tight, blending rap and post-punk into his best record yet. Its emotionally raw and confrontational tracks can be messy and uncomfortable at times, but it's also an album that carves out its own space and Slow Tide's most reflective album to date. Following that, London post-punk band Shame consolidates jangly guitar riffs, battering drums, and frustrated optimism on their latest album, Food for Worms. It's a noticeably more melodic set of tracks, with dense textures and complex structures, but there's still a decent amount of rowdy punk cuts that show the band haven't lost a step. Next up, once again on Red Moon in Venus, Kaliuchis shows her prowess as a talented vocalist and further proves her ability to create a cohesive sounding album. With its warm, psychedelic soundscapes and essential neo-soul tracks, it's a lush, lavish, luscious hot tub of a record from an artist who has really refined their sound at this point. Following that, Ozora Kimishima's debut album Reflected Smoke is a charming indie rock record with elements of electronica, rock, and glitch pop cut throughout the album's smoky production and laid-back style. Kimishima is also a playful vocalist with an ear for a gentle melody and a hook, and he utilizes that skill throughout the record. Next up, Cracker Island shows that 8 albums in, Gorillaz are still capable of producing a fresh, rich album that spans genres and moods with so many different textures and sonic ideas that never wear thin. Balancing bright, colourful electropop with a slight air of melancholy is hardly a new trick for Albarn at this point, but there's a newfound energy to things this time round. Next up, there is really nothing like Gazan right now, who follows up the politically charged noise rock album Cool with Anarchy, which is enough a loud and rhythmically dense rock album. Despite Gazan's eccentric vocals and compositions, there's something anthemic and overwhelming in the way these dense layers of chants and instrumentation come together. Following that, This Is Why is the first full-length release since 2017's After Laughter for pop-punk trio Paramore, and it's a welcome return for a band that's proven itself to be remarkably versatile. The indie-friendly dance punk on display harkens back to early 2000s rock bands like Bloc Party and Foals, with a slower, melodic second half of the album to unwind with. Next up, it's been over 10 years since Skrillex dropped the groundbreaking dubstep EP Scary Monsters and Nice Sprites, and his latest album Quest for Fire is a pretty triumphant return. His dubstep sound blends with a mix of electronica genres and an extensive list of collaborations with Fred Again, Fortet, and Missy Elliott, just to name a few. Following that, Pollen is the sixth full-length release for the indie pop duo Tennis, and it manages to keep up the quality from their last record Swimmer. There aren't too many surprises, but plenty of intimate moments over the 30-minute runtime. It's sweet and melodic, familiar and comfortable, and makes Pollen an album that is warm and fuzzy, yet is also melancholy and love-stricken. Next up, the fourth full-length release for the Scottish-based R-pop trio Young Fathers, Heavy Heavy is a passionate and often mesmerizing work, filled with short and euphoric bursts of neo-psychedelia combined with the communal power of gospel music. Heavy Heavy is both Young Fathers' densest album to date and their most agile. Next, Caroline Polachek's masterful pop record Desire I Want to Turn Into You proves that she's ready to become a force in the genre. From trip-hop to new wave, trance to flamenco, she delivers an effortless balance between ambition and accessibility, and has a blend of extraordinary vocal ability, florid imagination, and genre-bending boldness. Next up, 10,000 Gex is the second full-length release from the hyperpop band 100 Gex, and while it was always going to be difficult to follow up their debut, which was lightning in a bottle at the time, this is still a great record from the duo. There is a brilliant absurdity throughout, and the Gex playful songwriting and humor is never lost, even on the heavier tracks. Next up, the prolific New York rapper RXK Nephew enters 2023 with a steady lineup of relaxed trap beats, sustained flows, and witty gangster rap on his latest album, Till I'm Dead. His offbeat flows, range of vocal intonations, and stream of consciousness lyricism can be dizzying to follow, but there's also a relentless amount of personality across the record. Following that, the alt-rock band Screaming Females is back with another powerful record, Despire Pathway, which is full of strong hooks, rugged riffs, and desperate love. They've always made really damn solid riff-driven rock music, and when you narrow that focus into a truly vicious breakup album, there's a lot to appreciate here. Next up, 6 years following her 2017 debut, Kalela returns with Raven, a rave for the ages that explores themes of love and isolation both in the professional and public world. Brimming with synth undercurrents and pulsating grooves, Raven merges house and ambient, soul and dance to form a sexy, sultry masterclass in R&B. Following that, the Korean shoegaze artist Paranal made huge waves back in 2021 with his debut record To See the Next Part of the Dream and the follow-up Downfall of the Neon Youth. After the Magic is a worthy follow-up, and a lot of the tracks drop some of the harsher tones from previous releases to create a sound more uplifting and optimistic this time around. Next up, Land of Sleeper is the fourth full-length release for the British stoner metal band Pigs, 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 Pigs. Their sound may not be necessarily original, but they do it really well. And despite the heavier mix this time around, there's still plenty of fun, psychedelic moments with plenty of grooving riffs and tempo changes to boot. And finally, Travel is the 19th studio album by the Australian improvisational jazz trio The Necks, and it's a great introduction to their minimalist style and musical chemistry. These 20-minute studio improv sessions featured across the four pieces simmer with a hypnotic quality and evolve organically, akin to a late-night jam between friends.